The rope that the dogfish was tied on breaks, and he rips those bitch-ass fishes apart. Yeah, satisfaction! Anyway, the next thing is to enter the Poo Mountain, but hold on to your seats because you're gonna see some the most epic shit of all!
Haha, that fart song cracks me up!
Ha, farts.
Small minds are easy amused.
When entered, a voice tells you to give him some sweet corn.
Bring me some sweet corn!
Give him that, and he will make an appearance, just to find out that the last guy is a giant singing poo. And the best part is, the song he sings is a sing-along!
I am the great mighty Poo, and I'm going to throw my shit at you. A huge supply of fish come from my chocolate starfish. How about some scotch, you little twat?
Have some caviar.
Do you really think you'll survive in here? You don't seem to know which pit you're in. Sweet corn is the only thing that makes it through my rear. How do you think I keep this lovely grin?
Have some more caviar.
Now I'm getting blood on my dick like a nickly dinkly shitty little tag nut. I'm gonna knock you out with all my butt. I'm gonna grab your head and grab it up
your butt.
My butt.
Your butt.
That's right, my butt.
My butt.
My butt.
My butt.
Man, I've never saw so much shit in one stage before. Well, onward to the next mission. Jump into the hole where the great mighty Poo has disappeared into, and make your way to the top of the volcano. And to top it all off, you will have to convince this idiot that you're an elephant. What? Don't believe me? Oh, here, watch.
You're a squirrel, all right. And you're coming with me.
Look, I tell you I'm not a squirrel. Get your hands off me.
Well, what are you then?
I'm an elephant. Squirrels aren't short and furry. They're big and gray.
What?
Yeah, that's the twitchy noses.
They don't have them?
No, they're long and snouty. And they also have flappy ears.
Are you sure? Of
course I'm sure. See ya.
There's nothing quite like a good sh**. Now then, it's alright, that's not a squirrel, he's an elephant,
you stupid twat.
Oh yeah.
That guy just went full retard.
Never go full retard.
Precisely, never go full retard.
You stumble into the Stone Age, where you have to make your way to the dinosaur arc and sacrifice the baby to grant access to the stone dragon, where you find a dead caveman chief. You not knowing who he is just puts on his hat and steps outside. The other caveman will now follow you into a riot with the stone guys. But as making way through them, they praise you. Funny at first, but after 30 seconds, it will never go out of your head. After the riot, you enter the nightclub, where you find out that Conker's girlfriend Barry is now serving the mafia, denying that she knows Conker. Because you stole money from them, you have to do a little job for Weasel. You have to drop a bomb in the middle of the volcano to make it erupt and get rid of the cavemen. Quickly make your way towards the other side of the volcano to exit. But when you get outside, you get hit on the head by some cavemen on hoverboards. They rob you, and finally, they moon you. Oh, hell no! Get on your hoverboard and knock them into the lava. Finally, you crash to the arena, where you first have to fight Fangy, the dinosaur. Easy enough, just hypnotize him. Step on his back to ride him. Then it's feeding frenzy! Bon appetit! After three ways of dinners, I mean enemies. The big guy steps in. By first biting his dick off, then his ass. This game cranks me up. I love this.
Oh, that looks painful. How did they come up with this stuff?
Drugs and a very, very, very dirty mind. Once back in the overworld, the beehive is once again stolen. But this time you're gonna teach those flying assholes a lesson by blasting them into bits with the highest machine gun in the middle of their hive. Man, it's a pain in the ass to aim the thing.
I don't seem to have any trouble.
That's because you're used to the controller, you twat!
Chew on this, buzz suckers.
The next part is somewhat of my style, shooting summons with a shotgun you get from the Grim Reaper. Although it's a pain in the ass to aim this thing, it's badass to blow some zombie brains to bits with a double action shotgun with laser attachment.
You play too much Call of Duty.
It's common knowledge, now shut up. Once you mow down the zombies and enter the castle, you encounter a person that is known to all. Dracula! The nice man gives you food and wine, but all to find out that he was just stuffing you for his next meal. But he changed his mind to attacking villagers. He instead turns you into a vampire bat. And his errand for you is to fetch the villagers, drop them to the grinder and let him feed from them. When he just hangs there, just keep feeding the fat boss until he himself falls into the grinder, lifting the curse to make you back to normal again.
But take your time, because the BGM is awesome!
A thing we agree on, the game has some awesome music, from classic to even house! Now it's just getting the fuck out of here! But the front door is locked and you have to get 3 keys. Collecting them is a pain, because you have to pick them up and walk all the way to the front door. And not all dodging zombies and bats. You can't put the key down, and you can't use your gun while holding the damn thing. And talking about stuff I like, time to play some Call of Duty Conker style. It's war, bitch! The teddies are attacking. Time to shoot those plushy son of a bitches back to hell where they came from. But not before they shoot down a plane. The wreckage blocks the exit for the boats. The sergeant tells you to clear the way pronto. Easier said than done. To do so, you have to pull this guy from the toilet. And push them to each side of the wreckage. The left side is easy, but the right side has mines, so watch your step. When the way is cleared, the sergeant sucker punches you. You wake up in a boat on war to Ohama Beach. Wait, I know this scene. It's the same scene from Saving Private Ryan. In fact, the whole level is a parody of my favorite movie. You seriously save Private Rodent later on in the stage. A wimpy soldier who is actually of good use. His shield will protect you from everything. I love this stage, from the beginning till the end. Especially when you reach the bunker and Conker decides to get serious. And how to get serious? Light up a cigar and pull out 2 Uzis. That's more like it.
Okay, soldier, move it out.
Fuck you, teddies. Eat lead. Cool. A tank! Eat rocket, you bitch!
You enjoy this way too much, Rob.
Well, would you?
Fair enough. The movie is awesome, and the level is too. Can I play? Well, easy boy.
The last guy is a bit weird, even by this game standards. A doll obsessed robot teddy, which is surprisingly easy to kill.
An army of teddies, led by a little bunny girl with no legs. This game continues to amaze me. Rob? Rob, are you crying?
Rodent, no, not rodent. Oh, no, how cliche. Self-destruct button. Oh, shit. Run! Whew, made it out in time. Hey, Rodent is still alive, yay!
Oh, look at him go! Whoa, right in the windmill.
Hey, look, a passageway. Next level! Hey, there's Weasel with yet another job. But this time with Barry. And he even got a new fancy outfit. She's kind of familiar though. Anyway, they have to break it to the bank and hey, wait a minute. This is the Matrix! Awesome! This is exactly as the movie. Even Red Bullet Time. Man, this gives me a raging boner. Look how awesome! When in the vault, there are a lot of hopping cash. Chase the green stuff, and sometime later, King Panther makes an appearance. Oh, I smell trouble.
That was me. Sorry.
Weasel snitched, and Barry got shot down. Seems that the Panther kind of has belly trouble. But something is coming out. What? Really? Xenomorph? Now that's a final boss, ladies and gentlemen. Bravo! The professor who put the Xeno egg into the Panther launches the whole building into orbit. The boss is once again very easy, if you know how to aim. Open the airlock and you gain the suit from the movie. And sling the alien out the airlock Mario style. And he's dead.
Nope, he's not.
What?
Did the game just froze?
Better yet. Why is Conker noticing this?
Is he talking to a programmer?
And even blackmailing him? Ha! Original!
Alright. That's better. Weapons, maybe? Oh, cool. Let's see now. Yeah. No. What about... Oh. Oh. Yeah, that should do it. Double action. Oh. Oh. You guys. Yeah. Right. Okay. Take me back to, say, the phone room. Cool. Now, Mr. Alien. Let's see. Okay, let's get into position. Steady. Just check the shot. There we go. Right. On my mark, and not a moment sooner. 3, 2, 1, and action. Oh no, that's a bit volatile.
Long live the king! Long live the king! Long live the king! Long live the king!
Boy, Conker is one wicked game.
Oh.
Are you okay?
I have to go poo!
Thanks for the update.
Me.
Oh, hell no! Now that shit again. Not in my house!
Rob!
Hell?
Why is your poo singing?
I don't know.
I am the great mighty Pooh, and I'm going to throw my shit at you. A huge supply of tish comes from my chocolate starfish. How about some scat, you little twat? I'm flushing! I'm flushing! Oh, what a world! What a world!
Now that's what I got about it.